With our hands on our waist, let's begin by rolling from foot to foot, rolling up onto the ball of our feet, and then rolling back to the heels of our feet. There we go, alternating right and left. Good. Just working on gradually increasing the blood flow, increasing circulation. Nice, easy stretches. For those who are new to our program, I'd like to welcome you. And let me explain a little bit about our program. We always start off with the warm-up, then we move into our cardiovascular section. And there you're going to see something very unique. There will be two of me on the screen at the same time exercising at two levels. One is a beginner level and the other is an intermediate level. So you choose the level that best suits your own fitness needs. The beginners do no jumping. Intermediate people, however, do. And then we'll move on to our SOS section, and today we're going to concentrate on the waistline, show you how what we do with our waists here, and then it's our cool down. Just give you an idea as to what the format is. Let's count down now to incorporate some more movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your arms up from side to side. Just bringing them up across your body. Just very relaxed movements. The legs moving. That's right, good. Increasing circulation now to the upper body. And reach. We always do this before we begin any light stretching, just so that the circulation and blood is flowing throughout the body to the muscle sites. Let's count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on our waist. Let's walk our feet out. Just walk them out about shoulder height. And then let's take our arm and slide down to the right. Reach with those fingertips. Our left hand is on our waist right now. And then let's bring it up and bring it over. Ooh, nice stretch. And come on up slowly. Breathe out. Down you go. Reach with your left fingertips. Right hand on your waist. Stretch those fingertips. Right arm comes up. Slowly and over. Breathe out. Breathe as you come up. Arms are at shoulder height. And what we're going to do is we're going to simply bend. Keeping our heels flat on the floor, feeling a nice stretch in through our calves. Now let's incorporate arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Crossing down. There we go. Crossing down. Crossing right over your left and then left over right. Keep reaching. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms back on your waist. Walk your feet in. Stand with our feet together, knees together, and let's take our right ear over to our right shoulder. And same thing to the other side. Feel a nice release, nice stretching through here. And once more each side. Stretch. And last time. There you go. And bring your head up. Now let's begin our cardiovascular section by lightly marching. You should all be exercising on a surface that's well padded, well carpeted. You should be wearing footwear, just so that there's something to absorb a bit of the shock during this next section. Although for beginners, you don't do any jumping, so the shock isn't as great. However, intermediate people, you will notice that you will be doing jumping, and so your knees and shins will be taking a lot of the pressure. So let's help share that pressure by exercising on a carpeted area with shoes, just so we're spreading it out. We're not putting too much pressure on the knees or the shins. And now when we land, we initially land on the ball of the foot, but then we roll to the heel. And it's very important that you do that throughout this entire section. Land on the ball of your foot, roll to your heel. That's right, good. Keep your back flat. Now, what does she mean by flat back? Let me explain. No arching. None of this curving, no slouching, okay? We want you to try and keep your back as flat as possible. What will probably help you is to get up against a wall and try keeping your back flat. And you'll notice that in order to keep your back flat, you've got to do somewhat of a pelvic tilt, okay? Your pelvis comes forward a little bit to keep your back flat. Good. So now we've got our feet doing what they should be doing, our backs doing what they should be doing. The rest of our body should be very relaxed. Our shoulders are up, back, and our posture is very, very good, and we're taking big, deep breaths. Are you ready to count down? Let's count down now, and we'll branch off to beginner and intermediate levels. Are you ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, three, two, one, and hopping on this bed. There we go. Bring your toes forward, hands are on our waists. We're relaxed. Beginners are simply bringing their toes forward as well. However, they're not hopping, they're simply stepping. Good. Keep going. It's very important that you count down with me as well, because that's your way of gauging how hard you're working. If you're too winded to be able to count down while we're exercising, then you're working far too hard. Slow down the pace somewhat, okay? And if at any time you find that you develop side cramps, this is the best way I've found to alleviate them, is to take a big deep breath in, expanding your rib cage here, and then pinching right below your rib cage as you breathe out. Let's all try that. Breathe in, expanding your rib cage and lung area, pinch beneath your ribs, and breathe out. That should help to alleviate a bit of the cramping that you feel along your sides. If it gets too bad, please just slow it down until you're doing some light walking. Just walk it out. Never completely stop, even if you just go for a walk. Don't go for a walk to the kitchen, though, into the fridge. Not allowed, not during this half an hour. And also, try not to eat at least an hour before exercising. That may cause cramping. Let's incorporate some more movements. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pushing out with our palms. There you go. Now that we've incorporated arm movements, our hearts are having to work a little bit harder. We're working harder. Also toning up our arms a bit as we work. Working basically the fronts of our legs here and our calves. Most important though, our hearts and our lungs. There you go. Let's count down to change. You ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and kicking back. Hands are on our waists, relax. Relax your fingers. There you go. Roll to your heel. Good. Beginners are doing the best that they can do without jumping or bouncing. They're lifting up their heels to the back. Good. Big breaths, come on. Bring your heels up just as high as you can. Some people are more flexible than others. They can bring their heels up with no effort. Do what you can. There are a lot of variations that you can be doing. You can bring your legs up to here. Okay. Beginners, see, they can just step little steps too. Or we can all work hard, harder, and hardest. Bringing them right up. Whatever you're feeling today, push yourselves a bit. But listen to your body. Let's count down to arm movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and push forward. Palms out. There you go. Keep bringing your heels up. Good. Push out those palms. That's right. Keep going. You can do it. Come on. Push. If you're getting really, really tired, really, really winded, light walk. Slow it down. Just go for a little walk. Okay? Keep hanging in as long as you can. Don't get discouraged if you're a beginner and you've got to stop now. If you have to stop, stop doing what we're doing, but keep moving. Do some light walking. Come on. Stay with the program if you can. There you go. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on our waist. Jogging on the spot again. Big breath. Concentrate on your breathing now. Okay, we're gonna have to pick it up a little bit. Here we go, some polka tins. Let's try polking from side to side. Beginners are stepping from side to side. There we go. Side to side, come on. And again, little steps. Or increase them. Whatever you feel. Hands on your waist, relax. Come on. Let's polka forward. Polka back. Come on. And forward. And back. Forward. And back. And forward. And back. Good. Keep going. Come on. There you go. If you don't know how to polk, stepping your toe across. At least this is how I polka. Everyone has different variations. Do your own variation. Get your knees up, though. Beginners are stepping from side to side. Everyone's coming forward and back. Let's incorporate some arm movements. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And reach. Reach. Reach with your fingertips. When you're exercising, try and avoid clenching your fists. That causes a lot of tension through your arms and shoulders. Good. Let's count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Strides. There you go. Hands on your waists. Getting your heel down to the back. Working the fronts of your legs as well as the backs of your legs. Good. And again, little strides. Beginners are stepping back. So beginners can do little steps. Or we can all do big steps. Whatever you feel. Work out. Deep breaths. Less than a minute left. Went by quickly, didn't it? Come on. Let's count to 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reaching forward. Reach, reach. Come on, reach those fingertips. No clenched fists. Get your heel down at the back, stretch out your calves. Working those fronts of our legs in the back. Come on. Here we go. Let's go. Reach, reach. Come on. You got it now. Big breath. Keep going. Push yourselves. Almost through. We're going to count down shortly. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Meet each other on the spot. Very good. Keep your body on the spot. Rolling. Let's take our pulse rates. Come on up. Keep rolling. It's very important. Don't ever just stop. Let's take our pulse rates for 10 seconds. Locate it with the first two fingers of your on your wrist or either in your neck. Count for 10 seconds beginning now. Stop counting. Keep your legs moving. Now the number you've just counted, find it along the side of our chart and find your age along the bottom of our chart. Where the two meet should hopefully be somewhere within this blue area here. If not, don't be worried, especially if you're a beginner. You may find that you have a tendency to be a few counts below. That's fine, it gives you something to work towards. Right now we're off to a commercial break. If you'd like, take your sneakers off. Throw on a pair of sweatpants. Keep warm, keep moving, and come back for SOS. We'll concentrate on the waist. Feels nice to get those runners off and get into a comfortable sweatpant. Let's work our waists during our SOS section today. First, let's warm them up, and let's begin by stretching down to the right, just like we did in our warm-up, reaching with our fingertips, bringing our left arm up, turning our palm down, and bring it over for a nice stretch. Feel that? Nice stretch. Come on up, bring your arm up, bring your body up. Same thing to the other side. Reach down with your left fingertips first. Right arm is on your waist and bring it up and over. Nice stretch. And come back up and bring your body all the way up. Now with our hands on our waist, let's begin by just twisting and forward and twist and forward. Now when we're twisting, it's very important that our hips are remaining forward and our heads are remaining forward too. We're keeping our eyes forward. Keep your eyes on me. There you go. Good. Usually during our SOS section, we do have two levels, a beginner as well as an intermediate level. However, when we work the waistline, we do it as one group. Keep forward. Good. And twist. Forward. And twist. Forward. Twist. Now, it's very important that after exercising that you do keep warm. You keep your muscles nice and warm because they've heated up. And if you just stop exercising, they'll cool down too quickly and you're likely to get very, very sore. So that's why we throw on the sweatpants after our cardiovascular section. But sometimes our SOS section is quite demanding. So then we leave them off until after the SOS section. But during the cool down, if you have a pair of sweatpants on, you'll enjoy it even more because your muscles will cool down gradually and you won't be so stiff tomorrow. Countdown 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring our arms out at shoulder height and twist. Forward and twist. Forward, you hear some cracks and creaks? That's okay. And reach. Now make sure that you're really keeping your posture up as tall as you can. Grow 2 inches. Everyone reach up with your shoulders. Good. Get a nice stretch in through your rib cage. No cramping. There you go. Keep your bodies nice and long and tall. Let's count down. 10. Forward. 9. 8. 7. 6. Heads forward. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Now we're going to try something a little different. Arms are out at shoulder height, and I want you to reach over to the right with your right hand. And I want you to bring your other hand up overhead and reach over to touch your other hand if you can. And then let's turn our bodies, rotate, and reach with both hands and come down to a flat back. Reach and turn over again. Hold it. And come on up. You feel that working your waist? Let's try it to this side. Reach with your left hand. Come on up over, touch, hold it, and turn. Nice flat back, reach those fingertips, and twist, and come on up. Feel that? Let's try it once more each side. Reach, nice stretch. Make sure that you are bending to the side. Your hips should be stationary, okay? Just moving with the waistline. Over you come, hold it, and turn. Nice flat back, straight out. Back up and over. What's that growth on her back? It's just my power back, don't worry. Reach over and over. Hold it and turn. Nice stretch. Nice flat back. Over and up. Very good. Now let's reach up above our heads. Join our hands up there. Get a nice stretch in along our sides. And let's push down. Push right down. Feel it, nice stretch, and come up again. Reach up, nice stretch along our sides. Push down. Good, push all the way down. And come up, hands are on your shoulders. We're gonna twist again, twist, and forward. However, this time when we're twisting, we are moving our hips. We're pivoting through our hip area, and we're coming up to the ball of our foot. There we go. And twist, still keep your eyes forward, your head forward, and twist. Just working on stretching our waistline now. If you think back to what we did, we started by stretching our waistline, then we actually worked it, and now we're just working on stretching it a little bit, and we will continue stretching it during our cool down. So don't be alarmed if you're feeling a little tension, a little stiffness in through your waist. We'll work it out. Keep your shoulders up, hands on your shoulders, that's right, and twist, and twist. Keep twisting. You ready to count down? Okay, 100. 900, 1000. What's she doing? She's gone mad. Let's just do 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, concentrate, 5, keep twisting, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arms down by your side, and during this commercial break, place your hands on your waist and just bend nicely from side to side. Please stay tuned for our cool down, very important. I hope that you kept exercising during the commercial break, just doing some nice easy stretches. And let's continue with our hands on our waists, and let's roll around. Keeping our knees bent, although you can't see through the sweatpants, and I can't see your knees through your sweatpants, but do bend your knees and roll all the way around, hands around your waist. That's right. Don't go too far back, and when you do, Please keep your chin on your chest just to be safe. Don't want you rolling too far back. It's not a good position for your back to be in, okay? So just roll around. Watch it when you go back. Put your chin on your chest. And roll at every possible angle. Just stretch out all those tiny little muscles. There you go. Let's circle once more around, and then we'll circle the other direction. Right, nice and easy. Control it. Doesn't have to be big circles. Let's go the other direction. Just a small little circle. Just as long as you're stretching at every possible angle you can, all the way around. Reach up those eyes. Come on. Reach up your necks. There you go. There's a lot of difference between just rolling around aimlessly and rolling around and trying to stretch at every possible angle, reaching with your head, reaching with your neck. You'll get a much better stretch that way. And remember, these are exercises that you should be keeping in mind for tomorrow. If you find that when you wake up you're a little bit stiff, you should stretch. Let's go once more around, and then we'll go down onto our toes. Once more. There, go all the way around. Keeping your knees bent. And let's roll up, chin on chest. Roll that spine. Okay, now let's go down onto our toes. And let's just come up onto our knees, and let's stretch to the right. Reach at those fingertips. Now you can tell everyone that you can bend over to the side and touch the floor. They don't have to know that you're not standing up. Come up to the other side. Flexibility, my gosh. There you go. And once more. Nice, easy stretches. Good. And come up to the other side. Very nice. Now let's sit back onto our heels. I'm going to ask you to simply walk your fingertips out, bring your chest down to your knees, bring your forehead down to the towel, and relax. Now as you walk your fingertips out, you should feel a nice stretch in your shoulder blades. And walk your fingertips back up. Sit to the bottom on your heels. Support your upper body weight with your hands here and slouch back, keeping your chin on your chest, keep your shoulders rounded. Good. And again, come forward. Walk your hands down. It's time for me to say goodbye once again. I'd like to thank you for joining me here on the Everyday Workout, and I hope to see you again real soon. But until then, please take care. Be good. Bye-bye. Thank you.